the hearts of men. The shadow knows.
Before there were streaming services, satellite television, MTV, movie channels, pay-per-view, sports center, or video games, there was another device that entertained and enthralled its listeners. I'm talking about radio. In the early 1900s, the technology for transmitting sound by radio was developed, and on Christmas Eve, 1906, Reginald Fasten is said to have broadcasted the first radio program with Christmas music and passages from the Bible. It was not until the Titanic sank in 1912, however, that the radio became popular for mass communication, and it played a major part in World War I. After the war, radio stations began to pop up everywhere and became one of the biggest means for news to everyone. Radio also featured one of America's greatest pastimes, baseball, commented and narrated to audiences around the country so that families who couldn't be there in person would have the greats of the time, such as Grover Alexander or Babe Ruth, transported into their living rooms. Yes, in days of yore, families would gather around their radios to hear the wonders of music and the news of the world. Sure, there were silent movies, but the average household wouldn't get a TV until the 1950s. If one did want to go to a picture show, as they called them at the time, they would have to go to the theater. The concept of a television was a far-off notion. In fact, if you're wondering just how serious people took radio, look no further than the controversy stirred up by Orson Welles in 1938's broadcast of The War of the Worlds. It was said to have sent people into a panic, thinking that aliens literally did begin to take over the world. Throughout the early 1900s, on into the 1950s, radios were in the limelight. Soap operas, horror, and mystery theater, even superheroes could be heard over the airwaves, pique people's interest, and set off their wild imaginations. But by the time the 1950s came around and television began to take over, radio was considered obsolete by most. As pictures took the place of imagination, audiences began to see the neat visuals in person, well, so to speak. Television evolved through the years, becoming better and better, leaving radio behind in its wake. But to this day, radio has not died. But to this day, radio stuck around. It's even evolved into other things such as podcasts. You could still find Radio Mystery Theater on the internet. There are also audiobooks and virtual comics on various websites like YouTube. It's a way that radio still lives on and may for some time to come.
Who knows what it'll look like in the future.